COVID-19 blood-based treatment to be tested on phase 3 trials. A new study of preventive or therapeutic means for COVID-19 has been set. It is being led by the Spanish pharmaceutical company Grifols, in collaboration with the US FDA and NIH. Previously, the company developed a novel approach to treat the disease using hyperimmune globulin. Due to promising preclinical testing, government agencies backed up the company to push for human clinical trials. Now, the approach will be tested in phase 3 clinical trials. Victor Grifols, co-CEO of Grifols, said, "Grifols is very hopeful that all the clinical trials it is leading or participating in across different COVID-19 disease stages will advance as quickly as possible and prove to be successful." According to NIH, the ITAC trial will test the treatment for safety, efficacy, and tolerability when combined with remdesivir. The treatment is composed of a highly concentrated solution of antibodies. These antibodies can neutralize SARS-CoV-2. Thus, the label of the experimental treatment is Anti-Coronavirus Hyperimmune Intravenous Immunoglobulin, or HIVIG. The antibodies in the drug have been purified and concentrated intensely. This resulted in the final product to have more neutralizing antibodies compared to the plasma donated by COVID-19 survivors. Investigators in the trial suspect that administering HIVIG at COVID-19 symptoms onset will lower the risk of serious symptoms and adverse outcomes. The timing augments the immune system in fighting SARS-CoV-2 while developing its own antibodies. The use of remdesivir is because of the data from a trial sponsored by NIAID. The data recommended the drug for hospitalized COVID-19 patients, particularly in those with lower respiratory tract problems. Patients treated with remdesivir were found with faster recovery time compared to untreated patients. But remdesivir remains an investigational drug for COVID-19. The ITAC trial plans to enroll 500 hospitalized COVID-19 adult patients age 18 and older. The participants must have had symptoms for 12 days or fewer, but they should not have life-threatening organ problems. A total of 58 clinical sites are set by investigators in 18 countries in Africa, Asia, Europe, North America, and South America. The trials are randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled, and adaptive. Participants will receive either HIVIG and remdesivir or placebo and remdesivir. The dose of a single HIVIG infusion is 400 mg per kilogram of body weight. The dose of remdesivir is 200 mg for the loading dose. It is followed by 100 mg of daily maintenance dose for up to 10 days. Investigators will analyze the primary endpoint after participants completed the 28 days of follow-up.